You see, Jack. Romantic comedy is fun to watch. What is happening? Just watch. No. Maria. Please don't go.
No. Oscar, you came to this date with the dumbest choice of attire. Sorry, but no.
No!
Hey, turn that off. Why? This is amazing. No, it's stupid. That guy is stupid. He keeps getting dumped by this same girl, and he cries about it. And what is it with most girls on those shows are named Maria? Well, it's a beautiful name. It makes me think about the song from West Side Story. You know, the most beautiful sound I ever heard. Okay, enough. We can't really sing on Plotagon. Anyway, we are going to a royal wedding. I'm sorry. Whose royal wedding? Prince James and Princess Alyssa's wedding. I can't believe this. Well, I got this random DVD in the mail. Assigned to us. Good evening, my fellow strangers. It is I, Prince James, inviting you to my royal wedding, where we shall celebrate the love between me and my beloved Princess Alyssa. Tomorrow morning, and we kinda ask you not bring any cellular device or any devices, as I want it to live like it's the 17th century. I'll hope to see you there, my fellow strangers. Ta-ta. Okay. I didn't think you could actually put a video message on a DVD disc and ship it out to random people. And how in the heck did he found our address? And if he wanted to live in the 17th century, how does he have like a camera or a computer from where he lives in the first place? The 17th century and electricity don't go together. Electricity was invented one century later. That doesn't make sense. Well, no time for talking, let's start going. I'm not actually going, I can't live without TV. I honestly think you're bluffing. Oh, am I? Oh, come on now. I told you I wasn't bluffing. Come on, let's go. Next stop, train station. We're riding in an old carriage. I won't lie, that's pretty cool. Yeah, that is pretty nice. This is going to be an awesome trip. Again? Where are we even going? I told you we're going to Prince James' wedding. I have a question. Yes? How hot is the princess? Tucker. You can't ask those kind of questions when we're here. And to answer your question, I'm not sure. That depends on what you're looking for. Well, it still bothers me that we couldn't bring electronic devices. Could we at least get McDonald's there? Dude, I doubt they even have a McDonald's here, let alone fast food places in general.
I don't get it. Why would we have to ride in an old train compartment? And can we stop at a hotel with a TV? Could you quit complaining? And actually enjoy this ride? And no, we can't stop at a hotel with a TV.
I know they said no devices during this time. But I kinda brought a portable DVD player along with the B-movie. They said no devices. No phones, no laptops, no tablets, no DVD players. No B-movie. And besides, I don't think they even have outlets in the place, let alone electricity. This is really going to get very boring. Guys, why can't you learn that there's more than life than just electricity? Because the world outside electricity is dirty for my mental health. Now what's that supposed to mean? It means I need to be in front of a TV screen in an apartment, on a couch to live. You're not making any sense. I've seen you go without TV before. You've turned out fine, and besides, it's only for a day, we'll be home tomorrow night. So is this where we are staying?
Yeah, bro.
Two beds, and Jackson brought a sleeping bag. Well, I guess I'm looking forward to sleeping on a bed. Now let's get some sleep, we got a wedding to attend. I'm surprised that this wedding is even real. Well, before we actually go to the wedding, why not go shopping or even think here cost a penny?
Okay, we'll get looking.
Hey there, kid.
Oh, hey?
Would you be interested in buying some of our finest swords?
Sure, why not?
This is our well-known rapier sword. Two edges on its narrow blade. With 100 pennies, this sharp weapon could all be yours.
Well, I so happen to bring in a lot of pennies. From where I live, you can't buy anything with a penny.
Be careful, kid. It's heavy and sharp. And I always use it for good and never evil.
Well, do. I'll probably end up putting it up for a display. Jack? Where did you get this sword?
Oh.
I bought it over there. Okay. I guess we'll figure out where to store it when we get back. Let's actually go to the wedding. I can't believe it. Today I'm getting married. And I'll be king. I hope you're proud of me, father. It's time.
Oh my god. She's actually pretty hot. I actually agree with you.
We are gathered all here today to celebrate the marriage of Princess Elizabeth and Prince James. If anyone objects to this marriage, speak now or forever hold your peace.
I object.
Not you again. Look here, Otto. I told you we were done.
Let's just ignore him and move on. Very well. Sir James, do you take Alyssa to be your wife to love and to cherish from rich or poor and sickness until death? Now, Miss Alyssa, do you take James to be your husband to love and to cherish from rich or poor and sickness until death?
Don't say.
I do.
With that being said, I pounce this couple husband and wife. James, you may kiss your bride. Really? Guards.
I'm just here for my woman, that's it. I told you guys this is better than romantic comedy on TV.
Zir. You are coming with us. We can do this the easy way or the hard way.
Alyssa. If that's what you want. Fine. I'll leave forever.
Come on now. I know you're going through a heartbreak. But life goes on. Let's go.
This guy was so annoying. I'm here for my woman, and if she doesn't want me, I'll leave for good. Let's just go home. I don't like it here no more. 100 pennies for that sword? An actual real sharp sword? Yeah, dude. I honestly doubt they cost that much back in the day. But hey, with Plotagon, anything is impossible. That wedding was fiasco. But hey, we watched a princess and a prince become queen and king. That's nothing that we don't see every day. But seriously, I'm not dragging any of you to a wedding again. I'm even surprised that this was legit, like for reals. At least we know one thing for sure. That the princess was pretty hot. And there's more than life than electricity and fast food. Well, I'm glad you learned a really good lesson. Then how about we get that McDonald's? You read my mind.